SAP Predictive Analytics has two distinct interfaces. The application opens in automated analytics mode with options to guide you through the steps of using different types of data preparation and analysis. The Data Manager provides data preparation and manipulation functions, including event log aggregation to aggregate data based on events rather than calendar dates, sequence analysis to bring together transactional and reference data for analysis, and text analysis to identify word roots in textual data. Under Automated Analytics, Modeler offers a range of predictive algorithms including regression classification, clustering, time series, and association. Under Social are options to create a social network analysis to find communities within a larger population, co-location analysis to identify events occurring in the same location at the same time, and frequent path analysis to analyze sequences of events in time and space, such as traffic patterns. Recommendation allows you to analyze transactional data to generate customer recommendations. Toolkit provides a range of options to profile or transfer a dataset. In automated analytics mode, each task leads you through a series of steps on different screens. Many screens are specific to a particular analysis type or have elements that differ depending on the task. Most tasks start with the selection of a data source and the selection of a cutting strategy for the testing and validation of generated models. Some tasks require the selection of more than one data source, such as a reference data source and a transactions data source. For any data source, a data description is required to specify the characteristics of the variables. On the main tab of the Data Description screen, you can perform an automatic analysis to generate the data description or load a separate description file. Save the data description, save or remove variables from a pool of variables for reuse, preview rows of data from the dataset, or view the properties of an individual variable. On the Addition tab, you can modify the storage and value for the available variables, edit missing values, create composite variables, or group related variables. On the Structures tab, you can define or remove the structure for each variable and choose from a range of methods for automatically determining the appropriate structure. The structure refers to the nature of the values for the variable. For example, if there are groups of related values for nominal variables, or if there are lower or upper bounds for continuous variables. The Add Filter in Dataset screen enables you to add conditions or and/or logic to filter the dataset, remove specific nodes, preview the dataset, load an existing filter, or save a filter. On the Selecting Variables screen, you specify the variables you want to include or exclude from your analysis. The Summary of Modeling Parameters screen allows you to review your settings before generating a model. The Training the Model screen summarizes the modeling results, including measures of the predictive power and prediction confidence of the model. The Using the Model screen offers a range of options to visualize the modeling results, apply the model against a dataset, or save or export the model for future use. The options on the Display tab are specific to the type of algorithm that was applied. Many tasks generate model-specific graphs that enable you to analyze the modeling results and compare predicted to actual results. The Statistical Reports or Model Reporting screen presents a number of reports that illustrate different aspects of the modeling results. The options on the Run and/or Save Export screens differ depending on the type of algorithm that was applied, but typically provide options to apply the model, generate source code, generate KxShell scripts, and save the model. The Applying the Model screen allows you to specify the dataset to apply the model against and the name and output location for the generated results. In the Generation Options area, you can choose from a number of options about how to apply the model. The Generating Code screen allows you to publish source code such as SQL code for SAP HANA to apply the model directly on a database without requiring SAP Predictive Analytics. KxShell script generation enables you to output a model as a KxShell script that can be executed without the graphical user interface and integrated with other applications and program packages. The Saving the Model screen allows you to save the model for future access. From the homepage of SAP Predictive Analytics, you can launch the Expert Analytics mode, which is a different user interface based on SAP Lumira. This mode enables customized visualizations and story creation options and supports workflows including a range of built-in algorithms, as well as the creation of custom components based on open source R and SAP HANA Predictive Algorithm Library algorithms. The document browser on the start page of the Expert Analytics interface provides access to all of your items, including documents, saved visualizations, datasets, and stories. It also provides access to content saved to SAP Lumira Cloud, SAP Lumira Edge Server, the SAP Business Intelligence Platform, and a list of the connections used by your documents, visualizations, and stories, enabling you to manage your content by data source. From the File menu, you can open the Preferences dialog to change global settings for viewing data, charting, enriching datasets, automating software updates, configuring network preferences, installing SQL drivers, and optionally entering Esri account information for enhanced geomap visualizations. From the File menu, you can also access the R Installation and Configuration dialog, which enables you to install the open source R environment from within the application or to configure an existing R installation for use with the Expert Analytics interface. The Prepare, Predict, Visualize, Compose, and Share buttons enable you to toggle between the available rooms in the application. The Prepare room allows you to edit and cleanse the data in your dataset before creating an analysis. The toolbar provides access to common commands, such as selecting the dataset to view, switching between grid and facet views, choosing the columns to show, creating calculated measures or dimensions, toggling between datasets, refreshing values, or undoing and redoing steps. The Object Picker organizes the data from your dataset into measures and dimensions and enables you to search for specific items. For each measure or dimension, an Options menu allows you to perform additional commands. Options menus are also available in each column or facet header to perform additional commands. Values from the dataset display in the main window in either grid or facets format. Icons in the column or facet headers indicate the data type for the values. ABC for strings, 123 for numbers, calendars for dates, and globes for geographic elements. The Manipulation Tools sidebar contains all the actions you can apply to modify the selected column or facet. The status bar displays details about the dataset, such as name, number of rows and columns, and last refresh date and time. The Predict room enables you to connect your data to various components to create an analysis, as well as to view the analysis results. The toolbar has buttons that enable you to select the desired dataset and analysis for editing, run an analysis, undo or redo actions, save models, and navigate between the designer and results views. In designer view, you create an analysis, and in results view, you view the output of the analysis. Note that the results tab is available only after you've run the selected analysis. In designer view, the component sidebar contains the algorithm, data preparation, and data writer components you can use to create an analysis, as well as any models you've saved. In the analysis editor, you link your data source with nodes from the component sidebar to create an analysis. For each component in an analysis, a configuration dialog enables you to specify the desired settings. On the Results tab of the Predict room, the component sidebar enables you to select the desired view of the analysis results. The Data Grid view displays the results in columns, including all of the columns from the source dataset, along with any additional columns generated by the analysis. The Summary view displays a data summary of the analysis results. When you run an analysis, a number of charts are generated automatically. These charts are specific to the algorithms used in the analysis. This example is a cluster summary chart generated by the auto-clustering algorithm. In the Visualize room, you can create visualizations using charts. The toolbar enables you to select the dataset, analysis, or component node you want to visualize. This enables you to create and manage visualizations of your data both before and after running an analysis. The toolbar also provides options to apply sorting or ranking, delete the current visualization, refresh the visualization, change the visualization options, and maximize the visualization for a full-screen view. The same object picker from the Prepare room provides access to all the measures and dimensions in the selected dataset, analysis, or component. The buttons at the top of the object picker allow you to switch between the vertical orientation and a horizontal, faceted view. The chart switcher enables you to choose from a wide range of chart families and types to meet your charting requirements. You can drag and drop objects from the object picker into the chart feeder to build your visualization. You can also click the plus icons to choose objects from a list. Above the chart panel is a button that enables you to switch to related visualizations mode, where you can select visualizations related to the one you're currently viewing. When you're in related visualizations mode, you can select a measure in the object picker and then run an analysis to see the dimensions that are influencing the measure by contributing to its overall variability. The chart body displays a visualization of the objects added to the chart feeder. Note that objects can also be dragged directly into the chart body to be automatically assigned to compatible areas in the chart feeder. Above the chart is a filter bar, where you can add filters to restrict the data shown in the chart and see any filters that are already applied. Once a visualization has been created, it can be saved, which adds a thumbnail to the chart gallery at the bottom of the window. Note that each dataset, analysis, and analysis component can have its own set of visualizations. The selections made in the toolbar at the top of the screen determine the set of visualizations displayed in the chart gallery. In the Compose room, you can group visualizations into stories that organize the data in meaningful ways. The toolbar provides access to common commands such as selecting the dataset, analysis, or component whose visualizations you want to view in the chart gallery, selecting the stories you want to edit, toggling between edit and view modes, and saving, deleting, or creating stories. The filters bar allows you to add filters to restrict the results shown in visualizations and to see any filters that are currently applied. When creating a story, you can choose between three available story types. Boards enable you to create interactive, dashboard type sets of visualizations suitable for aggregated information. Infographics enable you to convey narrative messages using a combination of shapes, images, pictograms, and colors. Reports enable you to deliver detail-level data in a visually compelling way. The chart gallery displays previews of available visualizations that you can add to a story. The visualizations that display are dependent on the dataset, analysis, or component selected in the toolbar. You can also drag and drop the image, text, or input control icons to a story to insert an image from a URL, a text box to annotate your story, or an input control to enable interactive filtering of the visualizations. The desired objects are added to the board creation zone. Page controls at the bottom of the zone enable you to navigate between multiple pages within a story. The Story Options pane provides access to formatting and management options for the story and its boards, along with tools for creating, copying, resetting, and deleting boards. The Share room enables you to share or collaborate on your datasets, visualizations, and stories. The toolbar enables you to select the desired publishing destination for the selected item. Note that the item type determines the destinations that are available in the toolbar. Datasets and visualizations within the document are displayed in the main area of the window, where you can select one or more items to share. You can also search for specific items by name. You now know how to navigate the interface of SAP Predictive Analytics. For more SAP Business Intelligence tutorials, visit sap.com/learnbi.